Hello, I'm Professor Von Schmohawk, and welcome to Why You. In the last lecture, we saw that justice systems of two linear equations in two variables have a single unique solution when the two lines in the system intersect at a single point. Systems of three linear equations in three variables have a unique solution when the three planes intersect at a single point. Likewise, justice systems in two variables can be solved to find this unique solution using the substitution and elimination methods. These same techniques can be used to solve systems in three variables. There are also powerful methods for solving systems of linear equations that we will learn in future lectures, which involve the use of matrices. But before we see how to solve a system in three variables, let's briefly review how the elimination method works when solving a system in two variables. As we saw in the chapter, Solving Systems of Equations by Elimination, when using the elimination method to solve a system in two variables, we add a multiple of one equation to the other, choosing a multiple which will eliminate one of the variables. For instance, in this example, we could choose to eliminate the variable y by multiplying the top equation by negative 1 and then adding the equations. This gives us an equation with only one variable, x, which can then be solved to find the value of x. Once we know the value of one variable, that value can then be substituted back into either of the original equations to find the value of the other variable. Since in this example, the top equation is the simplest, we will use it to find the value of y. Substituting negative 1 for x in the top equation, we can solve for y by adding 1 to both sides. Giving us y equals 2. So the values of the variables which are the solution for this system are x equals negative 1 and y equals 2. This solution can also be represented as the ordered pair negative 1, 2. Now let's see how elimination and substitution can be used to solve systems of three equations in three variables. To solve a system of three equations in three variables, we start by selecting two of the equations and use the elimination method to eliminate one of the three variables. For instance, let's use the first two equations and eliminate the variable y. In this example, we can eliminate y without multiplying either equation by a constant. Adding the equations, eliminates y, giving us an equation in only two variables, x and z. Now if we can create a second equation in these same two variables, we will have a system of two equations in two variables, which can then be solved to find the values of x and z. In order to create a system of two equations in two variables with a unique solution, the second equation must be different from the one we just created. So we must use a different pair of equations than we used to produce the first equation. This time, instead of adding the first and second equations, we could add either the second and third equations, or the first and third equations. So let's use the first and third equations. We want to once again eliminate y so that we end up with another equation in x and z. We can do this if we first multiply the top equation by 3 before adding the equations. This gives us the second equation in x and z. We now have a system of two equations and two variables which can be solved to find the values of x and z. Using the elimination method, we first multiply the top equation by 8 so that we can eliminate the x term. Now when the equations are added, we get 11z equals 44. Or dividing by 11, z equals 4. Now that we know the value of z, we can substitute that value back into either of the two equations we just added to find the value of x. We'll use the first equation since it has the smallest coefficients. Setting the value of z in that equation to 4, we get negative x plus 8 equals 5. And subtracting 8 from both sides, gives us negative x equals negative 3, or x equals 3. Now that we know the values of x and z, these values can be substituted back into any of the three original equations to find the value of the remaining variable, y. We'll use the first equation since it's the simplest. Setting the values of x and z to 3 and 4, we get y minus 1 equals 1, or adding 1 to both sides, y equals 2. So the solution for this system is x equals 3, y equals 2, and z equals 4. This solution can also be represented as the ordered triple 3, 2, 4. If we substitute these values for x, y, and z into the three original equations, and complete the arithmetic, we will find that these values for x, y, and z are a common solution to all three equations. This confirms that our answer is correct. Even though we have not graphed the three planes representing the three linear equations in this system, we know that all three planes intersect at the point whose x, y, and z coordinates are the ordered triple 3, 2, 4. We can see from this example that solving a system of three equations and three variables involves more steps than solving a system of two equations and two variables. However, the basic techniques are the same. We start by choosing two of the three equations and eliminate a variable, giving us an equation in two variables. We then repeat this process with a different pair of equations, giving us a second equation in the same two variables. We can then use substitution or elimination to solve this system of two equations and two variables to find the values of those two variables. And once we know the values of two of the variables, we can substitute those values back into any of the original equations to find the value of the third variable. In this lecture, we have seen how to solve a system of three equations and three variables which has a single unique solution. However, we have not said how we know that this solution is unique. Perhaps these three planes intersect in such a way that there are an infinite number of solutions, and this solution is only one of them. In the next lecture, we will see how to determine if a system of three linear equations in three variables has a single unique solution, an infinite number of solutions, or no solutions.